Hello guys, this is Shreb. You're watching 5minuteMax, and in today's episode we'll be learning about binding and unbinding. But we have two students with us here in the studio. We have Saeed, he's studying dentistry right now, and he has no idea about probably what I'm using right now. And my younger brother Shakib, he's into business. So why don't you guys say hi to the my audience?
Hi, hello guys.
Okay, there you go. That thing's done, and 45 seconds also done. So I'm just going to take 5 minutes. The core principle of this show is just to give 5 minutes and learn about stuff. Introduce to Max every day. Not more than that. Okay, before that we have already talked about select object, moving, rotating and scaling. Today we are going to learn about binding and unbinding. Binding and unbinding happens in different ways. You guys probably don't have any idea what I'm talking about, but you guys will get some idea. Binding and unbinding is another way we have to say it, link. So I use the binding and unbinding because it's easier, because if I say okay, select a link, then it could be something else like a URL, that's also a link, but this link is different. This is binding. That means if I'm trying to bind the big box with the small box, I'm going to click on this one and drag it like a line connecting this one, and you see this little ants type thing. It's dotted line, and I'm just going to take my mouse to the object that I want to link to, and I let it go. And now something happened between these two boxes. We'll talk about that in a second. But right after binding and unbinding, notice the button is depressed. That means you're not on selection mode, so you have to get back to the select object mode, or pressing, you know, the shortcut key I told you other day, it's Q. So if you hit Q, it's selection mode. Now let's select the green one, which was binded or linked to the blue one. Okay, let's use the select and move, which is, I have already told you the other class, it's W, the shortcut key. Now let's try to move it up and down. Nothing happens, it's independent. So this is the child who throwed a rope towards the parent. In this case, a small one is the parent for some weird reason, but you guys have to just bear up with me, okay? Alright, so 3 minutes done. Let's see what happens if I move the parent. That means the blue one. The green one goes with it. So you have binded the green one with the blue one, so wherever it goes, the green one follows. This is the parent. Now if I rotate that using select and rotate tool, it will rotate with it. But if you try to do that with this one, the child is independent, the child wants to play and go somewhere else, you know, but the parent says no, you come with me. This sort of stuff happens with binding or select and link. Yeah, it is. Now let's try to learn about something flexible that he said. Let's try to unbind them. This is a wrong parent came to this kid and tried to grab the hand. Now we have to disband them. Hold on, control. Excuse me, I'm chewing betel leaves. It's called pan, so my mouth is a little pasty. So bear up with me. So I select both of the boxes now and click unlink selection, and if you unlink them now, try to select this one and rotate. Now the parent is free from the pesky little one. Okay guys, 4.5 minutes passed, so we have learned about select and link and unlink selection. So we are progressing every day. Keep watching this show and comment and subscribe to the channel. And yes, if you have any question, throw them at me and I'll try to solve. So see you guys on next episode. Peace.